We started collecting this ivory since 1985. We are just keeping them in a good custody.
I feel the weight of that thing.
This ivory, as you see, they have been registered. So the ministry level, these numbers are known. So nobody can tamper with this stockpile of the country. So even a single piece, which is here, this one is in Ngorongoro, number 27 of 2006, TZ, and the serial number of this, how many kg is 2.1, and the centimeter from here to here is 53 centimeter. So every year they are audited to see that no single piece has been moved from there.
What would you say the average kilogram is? Like
5, 15, 20, average.
So this room could essentially be $100 million worth of ivory.
I just can't believe the size and the weight of some of these individual pieces. So now you don't even see the same gene pool as the animals 50 years ago.
Now, if you go even in, you will see the elephants, they are of this size mainly, and below.
Let's go link up with the rest of the team. It should be landing in the next half hour or so. Three really good, strong people coming in with solid backgrounds.
We're gonna go to the airport, get the team through customs, get these crazies back to the apartments.
I was up there.
At the headquarters?
At the headquarters, yes. Big bosses, sometimes they just want arrest.
Sure.
Someone who doesn't know intel, they just think of apprehend someone, get ivory, get gun. That's all what they want.
You just gotta keep selling it. You gotta say, listen, if they wanna go after the big dogs, it's a process. You don't just go in and get it done overnight. You'll get there. Waiting for Knessa, Philip, and Trevor to get off this plane. Then all we got is Anton, and we're waiting on him. He's got a bunch of gear that he's gotta get shipped, so. I'm pretty excited. You excited?
Yeah, I'm reading this one. I'm
yeah, you look excited.
Yeah, because I will make things move.
Absolutely, I agree. Many times we're looked at as a threat or spies or something in Africa because we're Americans and they hear veterans, they assume that we're military right off the bat. And when I met Robert, he immediately embraced it and saw the skills that we have and saw the opportunity for collaboration.
You see what he has added?
What's the working permit?
For you.
Oh, okay. Our goal is to be a technical advisor here because that gives us the ability to train them in garrison and a training environment that they can go out in the field with them. They're using us as a tool because we're different. Pack your cameras, pack water.
And a smile. I've heard good things about the crater. Lots of wildlife. It's really cool.
I'm excited to go see the crater. Tanzania is beautiful and just can't wait to get the opportunity to see some wildlife.
When I think about the way these animals are getting slaughtered, and sometimes they're not even killing the animals, using chainsaws to hack part of their face off, it's amazing what people can justify.
In the sidelines, there's people that are fighting to protect these animals, and a lot of people don't know anything about it.
Got a rhino about 150 meters away.
Now it really feels real.
Yeah, you can watch as many documentaries as you want and think that you know a lot, but once you're here, it's humbling.
Quite an amazing end to the day, seeing the black rhino.
It definitely makes you appreciate being here and doing what we're doing.
All right, well.
Now we all got the motivation.
Yeah.
We're at Mbulu Mbulu, which is one of the best ranger stations in Tanzania. Kind of gonna get to see some of the best here. These rangers are pretty locked on, so it's really a good situation. So we're gonna go in here, talk to the rangers, talk to Elvis.
What's up, man? What's... Good to see you. How's your family?
Fine.
Yeah?
Yep.
Good. This is Elvis's station. Elvis is a really big part of our team, and to come out here and meet the guys that he works with is important for us. So we want to build that trust and the rapport. And once you start that relationship, then we can start moving more seamlessly together.
Mumble, I'm fine. How are you?
Good.
Nice to meet you.
So we're gonna come out here and see some patrolling strategies and movements. Maybe let them arrest us like we're poachers. See them rough us up a little bit. They are gonna kick our asses. Did you guys see any elephants today? I'm just here being a poacher. Good job, good job.
Yeah,
good job.
Really good.
Matumna.
Rashid Matumna.
Yeah.
Strong man.
Got good rangers.
I saw a lot of good things. Their movement patterns, their hand signals, their communication's really good.
Thank you.